I'm going to just say something to you guys just before, because I know it's going to be slightly distracting, and the answer is no, I look nothing like Kevin Hart, okay? No, I'm being serious. Quite frankly, I think I'm better looking than him, and quite frankly, I think I'm slightly taller, okay? Great, so I'm glad we got that out of the way. So we're going to move swiftly on. Over 20-something years ago, I went to a property convention. It was straight after university. And I bumped into this woman, and she said, you should come to this property convention. And I thought, you know what, I'm going to do that, because it's one of those places you can just feel nice and rich and posh and all that kind of stuff. And it's funny, because I used to wear tight jeans back then, and it was one of those ones I crossed my legs over and, you know, look really, really important. And it did hurt me, by the way, it did. And she said something to me that stuck with me up till now. She said to me, she said to us more, she said, when you work for somebody, that person controls every aspect of your life. When you work for somebody, that person controls every aspect of your life. They control what time you get up, what time you go to sleep, what clothes you wear, what food you eat, the kind of friends you've got, how often you travel, and all they want to pay you is £8.50 an hour. It's just funny how the people that we meet and the places that we go, it becomes a stimulus to where we end up. You know, it's a well-known documented fact that in mainstream drama schools, there's a lack of BME talent. I often will be surrounded by so many complaints from my peers, friends, family. There's no chance of us getting into these mainstream drama schools because of our color. Or there's not that much representation for us on TV. And I haven't been one to submerge myself in all these kind of complaints, even though they're fully, fully valid. For me, a problem's not a problem. A problem's a problem that can always find a solution. I decided, rather than join the chorus of complaints, to do something about it. And it led me, with my girlfriend at the time, I used the word at the time, and sorry ladies, I am now taken, unfortunately. With my girlfriend at the time, we went to all these different areas that I hadn't been to before. So we went to Tottenham, we went to Brixton, handing out flyers, we went to Stratford, we went to Croydon. I mean, if I can turn back time, I'll never do that again. Seriously, Croydon is one of those places, as soon as you get there, you're just knackered, I'm telling you. And also, like, one thing that points out to me about Croydon is that when I went to Croydon, last time I went there, I attempted to date a girl, but by the time I got there to the date, I knew we're not gonna meet up again. I really did. But when we went to all these different places, I started handing out flyers. And on these flyers, it would say, would you like to be taught by acting coaches that have been in The Bill, EastEnders, all these different soaps from back of the day. And I remember handing out these flyers, and it was quite a hard job because it's one of those ones whereby I had to hand out the flyers, and at the same time, I'm looking over my shoulder to make sure none of these guys are trying to chat up my missus. It's a really, really arduous process that was. But I just remember seeing a sea littered of leaflets on the floor, you know, with footprints on them. And at the time, I remember just picking it up and just dusting it down as on an A4 piece of paper that I cut in half. And I remember I'd done it for months. And I remember when we had the induction, out of the thousands of people that handed out flyers, only 30 people turned up. Only 30. And it's so funny, the look in their faces when they came to the induction, they looked at me as if to say, I can't believe this. The same guy that who's in his T-shirt and jeans handing out flyers is the same guy that's wearing a suit now and he's supposed to be our principal. But you know what? The wonderful thing is because of those guys who subscribed to what the vision was, that school, 15 years later, has grown from 30 to 700 in the UK. Wow. Students training every single week. And now 300 students training in LA. I found myself one time on a platform waiting for a train to come. You know, a typical day in the life of London Underground, you're sitting down there, You're looking at when your train's gonna come, and it says 17 minutes. You look away, it says 15 minutes. You look away, it says 18 minutes. And now, after I started the people watch, I just found myself just looking down. And I found that the platform that I was in was made of different squares, just different squares, equally proportioned. And in that very, very moment, when I looked down, I realized that the tip of my feet were within the actual outline of the actual square. And I looked to the back and I realized that the actual heel was also within that. And I said to myself, imagine that. 5'9" me. All right, some of you guys might say 5'5", but I'm 5'9". All I occupy in this whole vast world, all I occupy is this small space. And look what I've been able to do. And then I realized that this wasn't a case of serendipity, that is far more broader than that. This was down to God. It's that simple. See, for me, I'm not religious, and I don't like to really align myself with titles. If I was forced to, I have to call myself Christian. But what I strongly believe is that when it comes to faith and belief and relationship, it's not all about behavior modification. It's more to do with heart restoration. What I yearn for is a relationship with God. And what God yearns for is a relationship with me. And it's only those who can lend their ears and listen to his whisper, they'll realize that they are a gift. We've been made in the image of God. And that's the reason why I've been able to do whatever I've set my mind to. So if you choose to believe, it's really up to you. But I'm going to keep this moving. It hasn't failed me till now. Everything that I've wanted to do has come from God. And God has given each and every one of us a gift. And that gift is the gift of existence. I believe that all of us have been made for an absolute purpose. All of us have. And this life that we live is going on a journey to discover what that purpose is. I don't want to be one of those people that find myself leaving this earth and God give me the fortune to look down for me then to realize the impact that I've had on so many people. I'd rather know that now. I'd rather celebrate that now. For me, I don't believe in the R of religion. I believe in the R in relationship. And that's why I've been able to do whatever I want to do. The Identity Agency Group is one of the leading acting agencies in this country. It's also created a massive storm in the US. As Eddie said, I'm proud enough to represent some of the most forthcoming, groundbreaking talent that this country has to offer. John Boyega, who's the lead in Star Wars. Letitia Wright, who's one of the leads in Black Panther. Elika Belinska, who's now the first ever black Charlie's Angel. I think that deserves a round of applause, don't you? You know, there's a psalm that I just wanted to read out, and it wasn't to be some religious exchange, but for me, I'm one of those people that I just go, great, I need to speak to God. I open the Bible, and I look at it, and it's like, oh, my God, what's this about? Killing. What's going on? But this one wasn't. Psalms. You were created. You created my utmost being. You knitted me together in my mother's womb. I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. God does not make mistakes. And he hasn't made a mistake when it comes to creating each and every one of us. And when we talk about fear, fear stands for me. The F in fear stands for the failure to listen. The failure to realize. And if we can create that place for God to be able to put his throne, anything, absolutely anything that we wish to do can be accomplished. Thanks very much, guys.